Hey, what is going on, everyone? It's me, Mr. Mario, and in this video here, I'm going to be showing you all how you can upgrade your hard drive to another hard drive or a solid-state drive on your PlayStation 4. Now, this is a bit of a long process. I am just going to stress that here. If you go through the entire backup and restore process, it is quite slow, unfortunately, so I am not joking when I say you might want to set aside a day or even just do this overnight on your PlayStation 4 if you've got a decent amount of stuff on here. Currently, I have a 1 terabyte hard drive in this PlayStation 4 Pro I'm going to be using, and I'll be upgrading it to a 1 terabyte solid state drive. Now, this video is going to show the backup process, swapping out the drive, reinstalling the OS, as well as then restoring our backup, all in that order. The good news is, if you don't care about your data and you just want to start completely fresh and you don't want to import anything, this isn't that long of a process. It should only take about 10 or 15 minutes. If you're in that camp, you really only need to follow a couple of steps here. You don't need to do backup, you don't need to do restore, you just need to follow the process of swapping out your drive from your PlayStation 4 and then reinstalling the operating system on here. However, if you want to keep all of your data on your console, you are going to need to watch the entire thing here. So, to get started, we are going to need a few things. Of course, we're going to need our PlayStation 4. We're also going to need our new internal drive that we're going to be using. In this example, I will be upgrading my PlayStation 4 Pro from an internal 1 terabyte hard drive to a 1 terabyte solid state drive. So you're going to need to have that prepared, and you're also going to need a USB drive on hand. Regardless of what you're trying to do, whether you want to backup restore or not, you are going to need to reinstall the firmware on your PlayStation 4. So you are going to need either a USB drive that will be at least 2 gigabytes in size for that reinstallation file, or you're going to need an external hard drive. And that's going to bring up something important right here. To check your storage in case you need to, you can come up to Settings, go down to Storage, and right here, once your system storage is calculated, you'll be able to see what you have internally. Again, I know I already have a 1 terabyte drive, and this is going to be important here. It would be recommended to, as you can see, I'm using about, let's say, 350 gigabytes of storage on here. It'd be recommended to use an external hard drive for this that is going to be at least double that size. So in this example here, I have a 1 terabyte internal. I'm going to back up to a 2 terabyte external because that's what I have available, and then I'm going to restore to another 1 terabyte internal solid state drive once we perform the procedure to swap over. So all in all, to wrap it up for our parts list, we will of course need the PlayStation 4, our new internal drive, a external USB drive, our PS4 controller, as well as a micro USB cable to get it all plugged in, because we will need that for the reinstall procedure. You'll also need a small Phillips head screwdriver for when we physically replace the hard drive on the PlayStation 4. I noticed, at least for the PlayStation 4 Pro, a Phillips size 1 screwdriver worked perfectly. So now let's go ahead and get our drive set up for our backup process. We will need our external drive, so again, I'm going to use a 2 terabyte external USB hard drive, and we are going to need to move over to our PC. So let's get over to a computer and get that set up. So I have the 2 terabyte USB drive plugged in right here already. I have actually used it for another PS4, but in this case, you'll want to make sure it is either exFAT or FAT32. If you're using Windows, you can right-click the USB drive, go to Properties, and it should show right here for your file system. In case you need to format this, it's pretty simple. First of all, back up any data you care about off of this drive, because this will wipe the drive. Then you can right click, go to Format, and from here you can select your file system. It needs to be either exFAT or FAT32. For this, I'm going to use exFAT. You can do default allocation size, quick format is fine, press OK, and there we go. All the stuff has been wiped off of that drive. So once we have our drive formatted properly, we can then safely eject it and plug it into our PlayStation 4. Back over at the PlayStation 4, first of all, we want to make sure our external drive that we're going to back up to is our only drive that we have connected. So if you have an external hard drive hooked up that is already being used for your game installations, you cannot use that same drive for our backup. you are going to have to unplug it. So I would recommend at this point, you would go over, turn off your PS4 completely, unplug your game drive that you have, and then turn your PS4 back on. So once you're ready to start this procedure, we can plug our drive in. And you should get a message like this saying you can install applications on your USB storage device, but we're not going to be using it for that. So now let's start the backup process. Again, this is going to be a long process. So one thing I would suggest is go through your games here. And if you have any games, it might be a good time to clean up. If you have any games that you can live without and you don't want to bring over, I would suggest going in and deleting them. So you can do this beforehand if you wish to, and again, it will save you time in the long run here. However, I don't have any games that I want to delete right now. I've already done some of that cleanup. So once you're ready to go, you can go up to Settings, go all the way down to System, go down to Backup and Restore, and we're going to backup PS4. It might bring up a message on screen saying that trophy information has not been synced with PlayStation Network for any accounts you might have that haven't been synced up. So this would be a good opportunity, if you have not done so, to sign into that PlayStation Network account. Just go over to your trophies and make sure it is synced up. Either way, depending on if you want to back up your trophies or not, you can hit yes. It's also going to bring up a message saying that the save data here cannot be restored to any other PS4 than this PS4 for these other accounts. That is understandable, so we can say yes. Now it just needs to check what is all here on your drive. It is going to back up all of your applications. If you want to bring over save data, captures, themes, and settings, that is up to you. Well, I guess you can only check these three here. But I want to back up the entire PS4, so you can press next. From here, if you want to change any of the information, you can. I'm just going to keep all this the same. So now you can press X to back up. It's now going to prepare to back up our system. Just give this a few minutes. And it will now restart your PS4 to begin the backup process. And here we go. Once your PS4 turns back on, you're not going to be able to use it unless you want to cancel, which we do not want to do. But just give it some time to back up. And here we go. Again, this is why I said I would recommend deleting anything you don't really care about off of the system first, because this is going to take several hours. So as you can see, I have about 325 gigabytes, and it's going to take 2 or 3 hours, something like that. So with that, you just want to leave your PS4 here, don't touch it, let it do its thing, and come back in a few hours. Again, since you're doing this, it might be good to do your backup and restore processes either overnight or while you're busy during the day. Alright, so we're fast forwarding about 2 hours into the future here, and as you can see, we are almost done. So again, you just want to leave your PS4 as is and let it do its thing. It's going to restart once this is done. Alright, so now that our PS4 has completely restarted, at this point we are done with the backup process. So we are now going to need to not only prepare our external USB drive, but we also need to do the physical procedure to swap out the hard drive itself. So from here, all you need to do is turn off your PlayStation 4 as we would normally need to, unplug everything from it, and then begin the process of taking out the old hard drive and popping in your new storage. All right, so now for the process of physically replacing the internal hard drive. On the original PlayStation 4, if you look up at the top of the console, on the left side of it, you can actually remove that panel. So all you need to do is apply some pressure with both of your hands and kind of pull it away from the system itself. It should come off relatively easily. From there, there is one screw holding down the bracket, which is keeping the hard drive in place. Unscrew that screw and then physically remove the hard drive. There's then four screws that are securing that hard drive in place. Simply remove all four, remove the old hard drive, pop in your new hard drive or solid state drive, and then work backwards from this. The PlayStation 4 Slim and Pro are both similar in what you need to do. There is a hard drive cover around the back of either of these consoles. You'll need to remove the hard drive cover itself, and if you're having some difficulty, you could use something like a plastic spudger to physically lift and remove it, or just push it to the side. Once you have it removed, there is again one screw securing down the hard drive bay itself. You'll need to unscrew this one screw, and then pull out the bracket that is holding the hard drive in place. Just like before, you unscrew the four screws securing the hard drive, remove the old hard drive, put in your new hard drive or solid state drive, and then work backwards to complete the process. At this point, the physical procedure is completely done on your PlayStation 4, so you can put it back where it needs to go, hook up all of your cables, and then start up the console. Make sure you have your USB drive prepped with the PlayStation 4 reinstallation file, as well as your controller with a micro USB cable on hand. Alright, so now that we've performed the hardware portion of this, we now need to do the software portion, and for this we will need a reinstallation file of our system firmware. Not an update, we need a full reinstallation. So for that, you will need to take your USB drive. Now, if all you are doing is only swapping out the drive and you don't care to back up anything, you just need no more than a 2 GB USB drive on hand. However, if you decide to do the backup portion and you have already set up your USB drive, you can actually use that same drive to do the reinstallation. So for that, for anybody who has not done this already, you can grab your USB drive, plug it into your computer, right-click, check properties at least on Windows, and you need a file system of either exFAT or FAT32. If it is not either of these, you will need to format it accordingly, which means you can ext out of this, right-click, format, and then here you can check either exFAT or FAT32 for your file system. Default allocation size is fine. Make sure you back up anything you care about before you format this, and then a quick format is fine, and you can press start. Now, I'm not going to format this drive because, again, it contains my backup, which I do need, but from here, we have the USB drive all set up and ready to go. So now we need our reinstallation file. If you are looking to update or reinstall the latest firmware available, I'll have a link down below in the description to the PS4 system software update site. However, if you are on a lower firmware PS4 and you wish to retain that lower firmware, you will need that specific firmware's reinstallation file. However, wherever you get the reinstall file from, if you're using this for example, you can go to the system software update page, go down, and you want to look for download PlayStation 4 reinstallation file, and click on this button here, which will download the latest reinstallation file. You do not want the update. The update will not work for this. You need the full reinstallation file, which is about 1 GB in size. Now here we go, it should be downloaded, and if we check the properties, you can double check this by looking here, and it should be about 1 GB. If your file size is not about 1 GB in size, that means it's either an incomplete download, or you downloaded the update file itself, not the reinstall file. So now with our USB drive all set up, we can copy this over. So you can go over to your USB drive. If you don't already have one, you need a PS4 folder. And inside of the PS4 folder, you need to create a new folder and call it all capital letters, all one word, update. And inside of your update folder, you need to copy and paste the PS4 update.pup file. It should look exactly like this, and if you're using Windows, I'd recommend you go to View and enable file name extension so you see the full name. So again, on your USB drive, once it's formatted to FAT32 or exFAT, you need a PS4 folder. Inside of PS4, you need a update folder. And inside of update, you need PS4 update.pup. This is exactly how the structure and format should look. So now with all of that done, we can then eject our USB drive yet again, plug it into our PS4, which is turned off but has the new drive installed, and then turn on the PlayStation 4. When you turn on the PS4, it's going to turn on like normal, but then it's going to take us to a recovery or safe mode menu. Don't panic, that is completely expected. We have a blank drive in the system. Now, once your PS4 restarts, like I said, this is where you're going to need your controller as well as a micro USB cable. So all you need to do is plug your controller physically into your PlayStation 4, press the PlayStation button, and here it's going to ask for that reinstallation file, and it's going to give you the firmware version. So as you can see, this firmware is 8.03, and I have no issue reinstalling that. So again, make sure your USB drive with your update reinstallation file has been plugged in. Go over, press OK. It's now going to say your PS4 will be initialized, everything's going to be deleted, and we do want to continue. You might be panicking a little bit right there, but remember, we have a new drive in the system. There is nothing on there, and we're going to restore our backup, so any of our settings are going to go back onto the system here momentarily. Now, once it's done preparing, it's going to reboot and begin to install our update file, which is, again, going to reinstall the operating system and what the system needs on the new drive itself. Don't touch your PS4, let it do its thing, it's going to reboot one more time after this. So here we go, once our system restarts yet again, we're going to have to hook up our controller, press the PlayStation button, and from here, I'm not going to bore you with the details, you just need to go through the standard initialization process of this. In all honesty, you can just skip through everything here and not really care that much because we're going to restore all of our settings back to the system. Alright, so at this point, we are done with swapping over to the new storage. So if you decide to start net new, at this point you would just re-import your accounts if need be from PlayStation Network, re-download your games, reinstall any games from disk, what have you, and have fun. However, if you are choosing to do a full restore here, we will need that same USB drive still plugged in. And don't worry about how the PlayStation 4 looks right now, it's going to be reverted back to that same state we had just a few minutes ago. So from here, again, make sure your USB drive with your backup file is plugged in. Go up to Settings, go all the way down to System, go down to Backup and Restore, go to Restore PS4 this time, and you can find whichever backup you made. Now, to make it simple, I only made one backup, so select this, hit Restore, and from here, you can just say yes after you read this, and let it restart. So here we go, it's pretty much the exact same process we did before, just in reverse. So it's going to prepare to restore our system, then it's going to do the actual restoration process and write all that data back over to the new internal drive. Now, as you can see, it's still going to take probably about just as long as it did to back up. So for whatever time you allocated to backing up your system, you're going to want to double that for the entire process here. But this is again the exact same thing, just leave your system here running, maybe during the day when you're not using it actively, or overnight for this procedure, and come back to it once it's done. Alright, so as you can see, we are at the tail end of this process here, and just like before, we're going to wait for this to finish up. And here we go, once your console restarts, you'll see that all of your games, all your applications, all the stuff you had before should be back on here, as well as your user accounts and system settings that you might have tweaked on this itself. So that is all there is to it. The only last thing here is for any PlayStation Network account you had on this system, you will need to sign back into them manually, meaning you will need to know the current email address and password for signing in, but if you have that on hand, that's easy enough to do. From here, if you are done, really all you need to do is hold down the PlayStation button. I'd recommend going over to Power, turn off your console, unplug your USB drive safely, and from there, you can either keep the backup or delete it, it's completely up to you, but you don't need that USB drive plugged in anymore because we've restored our backup. But there we go, the process is complete at this point on the PS4. You've now successfully backed up, changed out your hard drive, and then restored your backup to that new hard drive or solid state drive. So hopefully this video helped out. I know it is a long process, it's not all too many steps, but because this is a little bit slow with backing up and recovering back over, it might take quite a bit. Anyways, that's about it for this video. Hopefully you all enjoyed it, hopefully it helped out. As I always say, this is Mr. Mario, signing off. Thank you all for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, a like would absolutely be appreciated, and if you didn't like it, a dislike is fine as well, too.